think digital services to the bottom of the pyramid can ever be profitable? What I'm talking about is there are a lot of fintechs which are coming in, you know, who are offering services. Do you think they will make money if they offer services to a person who is earning, say, less than 10,000 rupees per month? Is there a business model there?
If you ask me, but let me ask you, if investors who back various companies, right, I think they need to flip their way of thinking. They should insist that businesses that are serving the urban customer need to be profitable if they're going to fund them. And businesses that are trying to build something innovative at the bottom of the pyramid, they can be loss-making. That's how the investors need to think. But the question you ask is typically what the investor will ask. So if today you said as an entrepreneur, I have a great new product which will, you know, be sold to the, let's say, elite customers of Bombay, Delhi, Chennai, Hyderabad, but I will lose money for 5 years, you will find lots of investors. On the other hand, if you went and said, I'm going to do this in the bottom 5 villages or whatever, bottom of the pyramid kind of structure, and I lose money for 5 years, the investor likely would say, paisa nahi hai, how will I invest? Where is the model? Where will you make money? So this is, for anybody building businesses or segments, you first have to fight this bias of what investors want versus don't want, right? And capital is necessary. If you're going to build something for the longer run, so the same question, even if there's an entrepreneur business that says, I have a model that's going to work well for the India middle or bottom of the pyramid, and it's going to take me 5-7 years to build it, how does that entity support its employees or the investments it has to make? It needs capital in some format. In the Indian context currently, they're going to massively struggle for 2 reasons. Forget capital, they cannot demonstrate a revenue line. You see, if I build a payment solution as a new business, let us say, for that pyramid as that you define that structure of the pyramid, what is the use case I'll make and where will I get revenue from? What is the plan to represent? If the country's model is becoming payments revenue zero, how do I showcase where I'll make revenue from? Then I need to say, I'm going to give payments free but charge somewhere else. Where do you charge? I mean, then you start saying, I either charge for data or either charge for access, I'll charge for lending, or in a hidden manner, I'll charge for advertising. Like, you have to some revenue, otherwise why will investors, why will capital fund? So I think the big challenge for anybody building in that space first is these. Assuming they overcome these challenges, let's say they have their own money or they're willing to kind of find friendly capital to do that, can they build a viable model, which was the question? I think it's extremely tough for 2 reasons, depends on what goals you set. If the goal is to say, can we get 100 million customers in that pyramid onto the digital journey, but I will continue to be a loss-making entity and I'll be burning, let us say, $200 million a year, you can build it. Issue is what defines viability, right? In the current context, that's a little difficult to answer. Most large capital providers seem to think that burning cash is a good enough business for perpetuity. So in that context, you can build it. But the real question to address to my mind there is, what are you solving for there? What, you don't need to force somebody to go digital for the sake of it because it sounds good on paper. You need to see, what does it really make a difference to that person, that person's role in the society or in any format, right? If I'm somebody who's earning 10,000 rupees a month, going digital is not my first priority, right? At some level. And digital needs to be an option, not a mandate, ideally, right? Digital Absolutely. By itself needs to make, like today we all correspond through email. Nobody forces us to say, nobody says don't go to the post office and drop in a letter. To make natural choices is something suits people. So digital will, as it suits people, any structure of the pyramid, they'll naturally adopt it.